KaiOS and Android are both smartphone operating systems. What distinguishes them is not the type of device that hosts them, nor the type of approach that each device has with the end user. The real difference is the type of support. Over 10 years ago, Android appeared on the market as a touchscreen operating system inspired by Apple's iOS. Its strong point was its Linux base, which made it adaptable to different hardware, which made it accessible even at relatively lower price points. Android grew in an environment where at the time simpler devices still existed, feature phones, which supported operating systems such as Symbian and S40+, or BATA if it was a Samsung, which I still believe is software that could be valid and that Samsung itself has preferred to abandon in favor of Android, conforming to what were the trends of the time and that we find again today, in a much more diffused way. Smartphones have had the upper hand, and for them new operating systems were developed that had the intent to compete with Android and iOS. Particularly, Firefox OS, whose development on the market has endured for just 3 years until the 2016. Firefox OS failed its attempt to find space among the major operating systems for smartphones due to its philosophy that made it all too open and free for major investors. Although the marketplace included thousands of free applications, the exclusion of important apps like WhatsApp made this operating system totally useless in the eyes of buyers that, instead, preferred to invest in Android terminals. Firefox OS devices cover low market segments in terms of prices, and were therefore much more accessible, even in developing countries such as Africa. With the birth of KaiOS, born precisely from the ashes of Firefox OS, it was possible to obtain a historic compromise. With support for LTE and Wi-Fi networks, KaiOS has managed to make very common feature phones semi-smartphones. Its spread began on 2017 in the United States thanks to Alcatel, and in India thanks to Jio. Subsequently, its global diffusion was fed a year later thanks to HMD, with its Nokia 8110 4G, and many other devices, primarily Doro 7060 and Cat B35, took the decision to adopt this operating system. The strength of KaiOS comes from Google's investments, interested in this new operating system to spread its services in areas of the planet where the population is still without internet. In India, thanks to Jio Phone, KaiOS has become the second most popular mobile operating system. In fact, it was the first device to support WhatsApp in September 2018. KaiOS continues to grow, but slowly. The first useful update to get WhatsApp on the European devices mentioned above will come only in May 2019. The reason for this delay can be linked to the probable bug reports from our BananaHackers forum. Let me explain. For Nokia 8110 4G, the firmware update 13 was released in November 2018, while the firmware update 14 was released in some locations in Southeast Asia in December. Meanwhile, on our forum there were some experiments on root permissions, which to be possible required internet access through the navigator.kaios extension, from which any malware could access. The firmware 13 was sufficient for WhatsApp execution, as demonstrated with our sideload tests, but the device could not be ready for the official release of the application due to a critical bug of this magnitude. It was decided at the end of April 2019 to release firmware 15 in Southeast Asia, and in early May to release firmware 16 globally, much more stable and compact. Despite this update, HMD has kindly granted the Nokia 8110 4G the ability to debug and allow us enthusiasts and professional researchers to do more in-depth development of KaiOS. At the same time as Nokia released software version 2.5.1 on Cat B35 and Doro 7060, and to the Swedish variant of the latter, Doro 7070. From here it is possible to deduce that a group of enthusiasts has perhaps been able to provide external support for this platform. The answer is not certain, but circumstances suggest that we, Banana Hackers, who have provided some important information in some way. I publish this video to claim our right. In the hours in which this video was published, a signature collection is in progress on our forum. The thread I published has the title, Open Letter to KaiOSTech Partners, We Are Revolution. This is an open letter in which we ask KaiOSTech's partners, in particular Alcatel, Doro and CAT, to officially provide the tools and programs necessary to carry out these searches even on their devices that are still inaccessible today, due to the blocking of the bootloader and debug removal. Since KaiOS is an emerging and almost completely unknown platform, there is no real and reactive support able to provide the end user with timely software solutions to solve various problems that these devices are not without. KaiOS is a software with a free heart and great potential to be revealed and discovered. Being an emerging software, it needs the real and reactive support to grow and improve, especially allowing third-party developers to find bugs, report any changes and improvements that can benefit the devices involved. Blocking any possibility of access to the researchers of this platform makes no sense. The software can improve, but it is not possible to preclude free communities from carrying out analyses and research. With this block, we are offending the progress and the right to those who buy to take advantage of the rights granted by open source licenses to which it is not possible to escape. You will find the link to this letter in the description of this video. You too must join this collection of signatures, even with a nickname. Indicate country of origin too. Freedom is a right. In the case of software, it's a choice. Contribute to this research and let us help developers develop KaiOS, the successor to Firefox OS, the free software for mobile devices par excellence. Join the revolution.